Okay, so what you're going to need is you're going to need 3 of these candlestick holders from the Dollar Tree. You need 2 fish bowls or whatever kind of candle holder that you want, that you prefer. Doesn't really matter. I'm going to use the fish bowls. And you'll need some water, a spoonful of water. You'll need E6000. You will need some food coloring, which I got this from Amazon. And I have these skewers, and I'll show you why I got 4 of these. I'll show you why I got these. And if I didn't see already, you need aluminum foil. You need a popsicle stick. And your glue gun with Gorilla Hot Glue Sticks, which I prefer. It works, they hold better. And I'm just going to get started. First, I'm going to get started on the base of the candle holders. So, you will also need some alcohol and a paper towel to clean these. I already did mine, so. So, I'm going to start by the base of the candle holder, which I'm going to just take some E6000. And I'm just going to take a little bit of hot glue just for the video purposes to hold a little quicker, because E6000 takes a while and it'll slide, and you just have to make sure that everything is in order and not sliding off. So I'm going to use a little bit of hot glue. I'm not going to use it all the way around. I'm going to take the other candlestick holder, and I'm just going to place it on top of the others. Make sure that it's straight, because with hot glue it dries pretty fast. Have to wash the drips, and you can use some alcohol for cleanup as well. You have to just make sure that it's lined up correctly. Even with the hot glue on there, with the E6000, it'll still slide a little bit if you need to adjust it to a certain lining. Okay, so with this one, I don't need it, of course, not yet, not until I complete these fish bowls. So I'm going to set this one to side, on the side to dry, and I will move this one. So now it's time to mix up the color that I'm going to put in here. Make sure you just squeeze a generous amount in there. I think I'm going to put some more. I might not need it. Probably won't need that much, but. And then you just take your food coloring and then you just drop some in there. I'll see how I look as I go. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12. I don't know if that's too much or not, but we'll see. Then you really don't have to, but I just want to kind of make the Mod Podge a little more loose. So I'm going to try a tablespoon of water I'll take my popsicle stick and stir it up and see how this color looks. It's best to use a clear cup, and that way you can see if there's any Mod Podge still stuck on the side. You can just scrape it off and stir it up in there. So I guess this is how, I might not like the color for me, but I think it'll still be pretty. I should have went with the navy blue, because they have a navy blue. But it's okay. I think that's going to be too light for me. Let me see. I'm just going to try something different. I'm going to take the navy blue food coloring. This is the navy. I'm just going to try this. I'm going to kind of mix it up to see if it'll make it a little darker. So I'm going to try 1, 2, 3. I think that was 5. Let's see how this looks, if it darkens it up a little bit. And there's really no change. But that's okay. I'll go with this color. It's alright. We'll see how it looks once it's... I'm going to just pour the food coloring in there. And then you kind of just roll it around and let it spread all over the fish bowl. Trying to let it get all the way to the rim. Okay, so this should be good enough. So the reason why I got the skewers are to, once you pour, which I should have just let it drip into this cup. I don't know what I was thinking, but that's okay. You just let it, when you turn upside down, you just set it on top of the skewers so it all drip out and it won't stick to the aluminum foil. So I'm gonna use some more Mod Podge for this one. Food coloring. I don't need that much since I already got some in there, but I just want to put a couple more drops in it. So I'm going to do the same thing with this fish bowl. Okay, so this is what the glasses turned out to be like. It's a pretty color.
I like it. The edges is a little rough, but this is just for a video purpose. It's only to show you how I tint the glasses. So I'm going to use hot glue for this video because I'm going to end up probably changing this. But you have an idea of how the tinted look. Okay, so this is how it turned out. And I'm going to take some bling wrap. I'm going to take a 3-row strip. And I'm going to cut it out. I'm going to put it along the rim. I'm going to take some hot glue. Thank you. this is what it looks like. It looks messy because of the glue, so I'm going to take it and I'm going to clean it off, and I'm going to come back and I'm going to show you where I'm going to place this little gem, and I will complete the process of the candle holder after I clean this up a little bit.
Should I have both of them like this? Okay, so I'm just going to do this for now. This is just for video purposes. I'm going to take more of the hot glue. And I'm just going to place it on top of one of the flower mesh wrap. This is how it should look. I think that'll still be pretty. So I'm going to take the candle holder that I made with the E6000 and the hot glue, but I'm going to take this top base and I'm just going to put some hot glue. I'm not going to use any E6000 because I will end up taking this apart and possibly doing another project with it. Take this one and just place it on top.